In 1986, deep within the dark caves of Mount Owen in New Zealand, researchers uncovered something straight out of a prehistoric nightmare. A massive, well-preserved claw, complete with flesh and scales still intact. The claw belonged to a moa, a flightless bird that has been extinct for nearly 500 years. How could something so ancient remain in such remarkable condition? And could this discovery hint at other preserved relics, or even living remnants, of extinct species? The moa were giant flightless birds that once roamed New Zealand's forests and plains. Some species stood up to 12 feet tall and weighed over 500 pounds. For centuries, they dominated the ecosystem with no natural predators until the arrival of humans. But the claw found on Mount Owen raised an incredible question. Could traces of these birds or even entire specimens still exist in the remote caves and wilds of New Zealand? The claw itself was a startling discovery. Its flesh and scaly texture were so well preserved that it looked as though it belonged to a creature that had died only recently. But analysis confirmed it was over 3,000 years old, preserved by the cool, dry conditions of the cave. This sparked immense excitement among researchers, as it provided a rare glimpse into the anatomy and life of these long-extinct birds. One theory is that Mount Owen's cave system could house more remains, or even evidence of other extinct species. The region's isolated environment and the natural preservation offered by its caves make it a prime location for discoveries like this. Could the claw be just the beginning of what lies beneath the surface? Of course, the discovery also reignited debates about the possibility of living fossils. While there's no concrete evidence to suggest moa still roam the forests of New Zealand, occasional unconfirmed sightings and reports from locals have fueled speculation. Could the remote, unexplored wilderness of New Zealand harbor surviving moa populations, or is this just wishful thinking? Another layer of fascination is the connection to de-extinction science. The Mount Owen claw has provided invaluable DNA samples, sparking discussions about the potential to bring the moa back to life using modern genetic technology. Scientists have already mapped parts of the moa genome, and with advancements in cloning and CRISPR, some believe a revival of the species could be possible in the future. But the claw also serves as a stark reminder of how fragile ecosystems can be. The moa's extinction wasn't caused by a natural disaster, it was caused by human activity. Discoveries like this challenge us to think about how we interact with the natural world and how many species are still at risk of vanishing forever. After digging into this mystery, here's what I think. The Mount Owen moa claw isn't just a relic of the past. It's a bridge to understanding a world we thought we'd lost. It shows us how much nature can preserve and how much we still have to discover. Whether it leads to new finds, living populations, or even de-extinction, this claw reminds us that the story of life on Earth is far from finished. What do you think? Could there still be moa hiding in New Zealand's wilderness? Should we focus on bringing them back or preserving what remains of their world? Let me know your thoughts. I'd love to hear your theories on this incredible discovery. My name is Alex, and this is Future Past, where we uncover the mysteries of the ancient world and the creatures that shaped it. The Mount Owen claw may be 3,000 years old, but its story is far from over.